हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी इंट्रोडक्शन टू द गैस टरबाइन। नाउ माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस गैस टरबाइन फंक्शंस ऑन द जूल साइकिल और ब्रेटन साइकिल। देयरफॉर द गैस टरबाइन साइकिल इज आल्सो कॉल्ड जूल साइकिल, इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड जूल साइकिल और इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड ब्रेटन साइकिल, इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड ब्रेटन साइकिल और इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड gas turbine cycle. Now in this cycle, now various processes, let us understand various processes. Now in case of gas turbine, all the processes are flow processes, all are flow processes, means all are flow devices. Flow devices means open systems, flow devices means open system. Now my dear students, flow device or open system is nothing but, let us say here there is a system. Now inside space, the area enclosed by the system is nothing but inside space. Now here this inside space is nothing but system and outside space is nothing but surrounding. Now system is anything under consideration. Now for this system, if there is both mass as well as energy interaction across system boundary, here this is a system boundary, we can say here it is a system boundary, this will be system boundary, system boundary. Now if both mass as well as energy crosses the system boundary, then it is called open system. Means energy can enter into the system, energy can leave the system. There will be an energy interaction across system boundary. As well as the mass can enter into the system and mass can leave the system. It is called open system or flow processes. And my dear students, in case of non-flow processes or closed system, there is no mass transfer. There is only energy transfer across the system boundary. And in case of isolated system, there is no mass as well as there is no energy transfer across the system boundary. Now here, as all are flow processes, therefore all are open system, therefore there will be a both mass as well as energy interaction across the system boundary. Now in case of Brayton cycle or Joule cycle, that is called gas turbine cycle, there are four flow devices, right? We can say actually there are three flow devices and other is a atmosphere, right? The fourth one is the atmosphere and three flow devices. Now here the atmospheric air, let us say the atmospheric air is at condition one, therefore condition one is atmospheric air, atmospheric air, we can say the condition is one, right? Now this atmospheric air is taken and this is compressed in compressor. Here you will find the compressor, and this compression from one to two, it is reversible adiabatic compression. Therefore various processes are, very first process, process 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic, reversible adiabatic compression. Reversible adiabatic is also called isentropic, it is also called isentropic compression, right? And therefore, as my dear students, as it is reversible adiabatic compression, therefore we need here compressor, right? Therefore it is in compressor, the process is compressor process, right? The first device, first open system is compressor. Now as air is compressed, the temperature of air increases. Now this air and volume decreases and pressure also increases. Now this compressed air, that is high temperature, high pressure air, is passed to combustion chamber. Here there will be a combustion chamber, combustion chamber, we can say CC, combustion chamber we can denote with CC, right? Here compression is reversible adiabatic, that means PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. This equation is followed for compressor, or entropy is constant during compressor, that is isentropic compression. Now in case of combustion chamber, heat is supplied at constant pressure. Therefore my dear students, from 2 to 3, heat is supplied at constant pressure in combustion chamber. Therefore second process is 2 to 3 is nothing but constant pressure heat supply, constant pressure heat supply in combustion chamber, in combustion chamber, right? Now once the heat is supplied, after supply of heat, this air, now this condition of gas is passed through the turbine, right? Now this is given to the turbine now, where it generates the work. Turbine produces the net work or work output, work of turbine, we can say it is the work of turbine, right? Now it is passed through turbine from 3 to 4. And my dear students, this turbine is reversible adiabatic expansion. Turbine is nothing but reversible adiabatic expansion. Hence, this turbine follows PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. This equation, that is entropy is constant. Therefore, we can say 3 to 4 is reversible adiabatic expansion. Reversible adiabatic. Reversible adiabatic is also called isentropic. It is isentropic expansion, right? Or reversible adiabatic expansion. And it is in turbine. Therefore, it is a turbine process. Turbine process, right? And my dear students, after reversible adiabatic expansion, the turbine will produce work. And the exhaust of turbine is given to the atmosphere. Again, the four condition is 2 atmosphere. 2 atmosphere. So, my dear students, the atmospheric air is taken and after expansion process, it is given to the atmosphere. Means, whatever may be the heat available in this exhaust air, the heat is rejected to the atmosphere and atmospheric pressure is constant. That means we can say P1 is equal to P4 is equal to P atmospheric. Therefore, we can say 4 to 1 is constant pressure heat rejection, right? Therefore, 4 to 1 is constant pressure. At constant pressure, heat is rejected. Constant pressure, heat rejection. And it is in to the atmosphere. To atmosphere, right? Therefore, my dear students, here we have actually three devices. That is, first is compressor, then combustion chamber, and then turbine. And the fourth device, it is actually not a device, but the fourth is atmosphere. Here we have atmosphere, right? This is how there is a gas turbine or Joule cycle or Brayton cycle. And my dear students, through each and every device, the air or atmospheric condition is flowing, right? Atmospheric air is flowing. Therefore, as air is flowing, the mass is flowing. Therefore, all are flow processes or all are open system processes, right? Now, let us draw this Brayton cycle or Joule cycle or gas turbine cycle on pressure versus volume as well as temperature versus entropy diagram. Now the cycle PV cycle is PV diagram. Let us say pressure versus volume diagram. Now in case of pressure versus volume diagram and in case of temperature versus entropy diagram, temperature versus entropy diagram, we are going to draw the Brayton cycle or gas turbine cycle. Now very first process is reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic compression. Therefore from 1 to 2. It is compressed reversible adiabatically. Here 1 to 2 reversible adiabatic compression. Let us say 1 is somewhere here, right? 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic compression. Now therefore reversible adiabatic compression means isentropic compression, and during this process entropy remains constant and temperature increases. Therefore from 1 to 2 temperature increases at constant entropy. 1 to 2 temperature increases at constant entropy, or PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Now 2 to 3 is constant pressure heat supply in combustion chamber. Therefore, at constant pressure, heat is supplied. Therefore, volume increases. As heat is supplied at constant pressure, volume increases. Therefore, at constant pressure, we will get 3 point on PV diagram. And at constant pressure, if heat is supplied, entropy will increase as well as temperature will increase. Therefore, 2 to 3, the constant pressure process will be like this on TS diagram. This will be the constant pressure process 2 to 3. Now, 3 to 4. 3 to 4 is again reversible adiabatic expansion, that is isentropic expansion in turbine. Therefore, as it is expansion, therefore, during this process, the volume increases, pressure decreases, as it is reversible adiabatic expansion, that is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. 3 to 4. And my dear students, on TS diagram, as it is reversible adiabatic, means it is isentropic, entropy remains constant, and during isentropic expansion, temperature decreases. Therefore, 3 to 4, temperature decreases at constant entropy. Right? Entropy remains constant and temperature decreases. Now, the last process is constant pressure heat rejection to the atmosphere. Therefore, from 4 to 1, it is constant pressure process, and during this process, heat is rejected to the surrounding. Right? Therefore, 4 to 1 on TS diagram, heat is rejected to the surrounding. Therefore, temperature decreases and entropy also decreases. Therefore, it is a constant pressure heat rejection. Now, this cycle on PV and TS diagram is called Brayton cycle. This is our Brayton cycle. So my dear students, in next lecture we are going to do analysis of this Brayton cycle. Thank you dear students. In next lecture we will find efficiency thermal of this Brayton cycle.